Good morning, students. I am Manikant Mishra, Modern English School, New Area. So yesterday we had discussed about the physical properties of metal and non-metal. So some of you have asked about the allotropy, an element which exist in more than one form, an element which exists in more than one form having the similar chemical properties but of the different physical properties is called allotropy, and the phenomenon is called allotropy. Metal do not show allotropy, whereas non-metal show allotropy. Like a carbon has allotropy, that graphite and diamond. Similarly, sulfur also exhibit allotropy, like a yellow rhombic sulfur, monoclinic sulfur, and so on. So now let us talk today about the chemical properties of metal. My dear student, when we talk about the chemical reactivity of metal, so keep in your mind, please, it is nothing but the rate of losing electron. The metal which readily loses electron are considered to be a reactive metal. So metal which easily loses electron are considered to be reactive metal, whereas those have tendency to lose in a moderate rate are medium range of reactivity, and which do not have tendency to lose with very difficult by expensing lot of amount of energy, then those metals are least reactive metal. So like often we see that whenever we talk about the reactivity that comes in our mind, that sodium potassium are highly reactive metal. Why not? Because it readily loses the electron, that's why it reacts with oxygen at room temperature itself. So first, reaction of metal with oxygen. Once again, I make it clear, please keep it in mind. Metal, it means rate of losing electron. On the other hand, if you talk about the reactivity of non-metal, it means the rate of receiving electron. Non-metal which can readily receive electron are highly reactive. So now, reaction of metal with oxygen. First, reaction of metal with oxygen. Metal react with oxygen forms metallic oxide, but different metals react at different condition. As for example, sodium potassium react at room temperature itself, but magnesium, aluminium, zinc require strong heating. On the other hand, iron and copper need prolonged heating. Metal like silver, gold, platinum not affected by air. So, chemical properties of metal. Chemical properties of metal. So, sodium reacts with oxygen at room temperature itself and forms sodium oxide. Potassium reacts with oxygen, form potassium oxide. At room temperature itself catches fire. This is the reason that sodium potassium are kept under the kerosene oil so that there will be
no connection of metal, sodium metal and potassium metal with air. On the other hand, magnesium require little amount of heat, then it reacts with oxygen. So sodium burns with oxygen with yellow flame, golden yellow flame. Magnesium, when magnesium reacts with oxygen, it burns with a dazzling white light. It reacts with oxygen, or it burns in oxygen with a dazzling white light. Now zinc reacts with oxygen, forms zinc oxide. Aluminium reacts with oxygen, forms aluminium oxide. Iron reacts with oxygen, forms mixed oxide, like a ferrous oxide, iron 2 oxide and iron 3 oxide. Iron 2 oxide and iron 3 oxide, together it is a Fe3O4, it is a mixed oxide. Fe3O4 is called mixed oxide. So when iron reacts with oxygen, it forms two oxide, ferrous oxide and ferric oxide. Ferrous oxide is also called iron 2 oxide, and ferric oxide is also called iron 3 oxide. It means iron exhibits two valency, +2 and +3. So when these two oxides are mixed together, then forms Fe3O4. It is called mixed oxide. It is an example of a mixed oxide. Now next,
metallic oxide is a basic in nature. How do we prove this activity? Metallic oxide is a basic in nature. So when you burn the magnesium ribbon, while burning, it gives a white ash. Those white ash you put in a hot water and dissolve it. And the resulting solution, you pass through the red litmus solution, then red litmus turns to blue. Then on this basis, we can conclude the metallic oxides are basic in nature. Not only with the magnesium oxide, we can do with the sodium oxide plus water forms aqueous solution of sodium hydroxide, which is a basic in nature. Potassium hydroxide, basic in nature. Calcium oxide plus water, calcium hydroxide, its aqueous solution is also basic in nature. So we can conclude that metallic oxides are basic in nature. Though some of the metallic oxides are amphoteric in nature also. What is amphoteric oxide?
The metallic oxide which behaves acidic as well as basic under certain circumstances. Metallic oxide whose behavior is acidic as well as basic under certain condition, as for example aluminium oxide and zinc oxide. Aluminium oxide reacts with acid, forms salt and water. Here aluminium oxide behave as a base, and when aluminium oxide reacts with the sodium hydroxide, forms sodium aluminate and water. In this reaction, it behaves as an acid.
So this aluminium oxide is an example of a amphoteric oxide. Now next, chemical properties of metal. Metal reacts with water. And the reactivity of reaction between metal and water also varies from metal to metal. Like sodium potassium react with the cold water. Even calcium also react with cold water. But magnesium Aluminium, zinc do not react with cold water, rather they need steam.
Magnesium though react with the boiling of water also. So magnesium react with boiling water, but aluminium and zinc react with steam.
Iron, if iron pass through the steam, it doesn't react.
Rather, it need a red hot iron pass through. Red hot iron pass through the steam, then it reacts and forms a mixed oxide.
Metals like a copper, silver, gold, platinum do not react even with the steam because this reactivity are very less reactive than hydrogen. So here you see the reaction. Sodium reacts with water, forms sodium hydroxide and hydrogen. Potassium reacts with water, forms potassium hydroxide and hydrogen. The reaction is so violent and exothermic, the hydrogen gas evolved catches fire.
Due to exothermic nature, the heat so evolved, the hydrogen gas catch fire. Hydrogen gas catch fire.
Now, reaction with the calcium metal and water. Calcium reacts with water, forms calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas.
Due to formation of a hydrogen gas bubble, calcium metal starts to float.
Now next, magnesium reacts with boiling water, forms magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Zinc react with steam, form zinc oxide and hydrogen gas, and this aluminium react with steam, forms aluminium oxide and hydrogen gas.
And we have already discussed in previous lesson how do we check whether the evolved gas is only hydrogen. Now next, iron, red hot iron, when it is a pass through, when it is a pass through hydrogen, then steam, then it reacts and forms a mixed oxide Fe3O4 plus H2. But metal like copper, silver, gold, platinum do not react because this reactivity is less than hydrogen. They are not able to lose electron. So this mechanism I tried to make you understand. First of all, as you know that the water is a weak electrolyte, so slightly it ionized in the form of H plus and OH minus. This metal loses one electron and forms M plus an electron. Now this electron is received by this hydrogen ion and convert into hydrogen atom. But as you know that hydrogen atom cannot exist in nature, so it immediate combine with another hydrogen atom and convert into hydrogen gas. So what I am trying to make you understand, my dear student, the metal which will be able to lose electron, then only this reaction is possible, otherwise not. It is true with the case of acid also, that we have discussed in the acid chapter also, this mechanism. So thank you, have a nice day.